Hello there, Ray here, and the latest snapshot 18W10D has came out. This is part of the aquatic update for 1.13, and with it we got some new naturally generating coral, as well as more blocks added to being waterlogged, and more quirky bugs added into this game, as well as some removed. So right off the bat, you see that they have added in coral reefs. You see they contain the new coral blocks, as well as the coral plants. And these come in the warm oceans. You see they're quite dense, and they kind of stay all into the same area. This one here is kind of surrounding this main island, and it surrounds all the way to the back side of it. But once it comes over to the cold biome, you see that it doesn't spread over into the other biome. It has a lot of characteristics of a real coral, where you see different variations of corals growing on top of each other, as well as different plants growing on top of the coral. And they kind of spread out, but they also stay kind of in little bunches. You see different variations. Some are kind of like the flat type, and some are more of the ones that try to grow upwards. And like I've seen where over here, like some are more like shells, like it's almost like a little hut inside of here. They added in more blocks that can be waterlogged. So we added in trap doors, so you can put water in those, as well as signs, like ones that are standing up, as well as the wall ones, and also ladders. Chests can also be waterlogged by shift clicking water onto them, something I didn't show in the last snapshot, and the water will flow out from them. And they also change it so that water inside of blocks that have a solid side will not allow water to flow beyond them. So like this stair here, water can't flow out. But if you break this block here, the water is able to flow out the other sides. As before with the other blocks, you can also remove the water and by clicking onto the actual block. So with the chest, you have to shift click the water off of it. You can click on the ladder and take it off. But for signs, you can't click on the sign. But if you kind of wiggle your bucket around in the water, you're able to pick it up. It's kind of strange. Same goes from here. Just keep wiggling around. You're able to pick it up. It also doesn't make any noise. And you can do the same for like trapdoors. Yeah, I don't know what. It's such a weird mechanic. I'm not sure if that's intended. Now the trapdoor follows the same property as the stairs, where if it has a solid back, it won't allow the water to flow into that block area, but will be able to flow the other directions. The cool thing about trapdoors is that when you close them, it does allow water to flow over there. And then you could open it up again, and this water is essentially like budded. So if you update it, then it will break. And if you let the water flow over there really quickly, it will also get removed shortly after. So it might be a cool way to send like a signal over to something with like, if you had like observer at the end of it, then you would break it. And then you can cause like update. I guess you have to update this one right beside it for it to break. Now for signs, it's a little bit different. If you would place the water in first and then remove the blocks beside it, it will not cause any updates, so you can have floating water with it. But if you would first make room for the water to flow and then place the water in, then it would flow out to the outside. Now if you would place a sign up against a ghost block, then you would have a floating sign, and therefore you can make floating water sources with just a sign. They also added so that shulker boxes can now be dyed back to the original color. So if I just right click on this cauldron with my shulker box in hand that was dyed, you can see it went back to the default purple color, and they just call this one a shulker box. And here's my orange one, and I'll right click it, and this will use up one level of the cauldron. Now they also said they optimized the way that they rendered the clouds, and these are fancy clouds, and you can change your setting for your cloud right here. A lot of times I would keep my clouds off or put them on fast, just because they would actually be noticeably more leggier for me, so that's how I kept them. But even with fancy clouds, it seems that they're really nice. They look amazing as always, but I definitely can tell that there is a change. Now they also added it so the phantoms will now burn in the daytime, but you can see the rendering's not quite right. The phantom is pretty much rendering over top of this water, but it makes sense that the phantoms would burn in the daylight now that they are an undead mob, and this way you don't have to worry about them being around bothering you in the daytime. But just like zombies, you can store them with a block above them, so this way they don't get the skylight access and they won't burn up. They made some changes to the coral plant with this version. It used to be that you needed 2 meters of water for the coral plant to be able to be placed down. So now you can stick coral in 1 deep worth of water and it will stay there. If you also remove the blocks beside it, it will contain its water and won't flow out. And this water works very similar to as we've seen with the water that is lodged inside of the like slabs and stuff. So if you look at this one over the right hand side would say it's waterlogged, true, but with like the coral, it doesn't have any non-waterlogged state. So it's always considered like a waterlog. And it does have the same properties of the water too. As you can see, we can make like a cobble generator using it. And the coral plants can now hold themselves up, so you can remove the block underneath them and they won't break off. Now the red coral doesn't seem as vibrant as the previous snapshot. It looks a little bit dull. And you can even notice that when we take it out of the water, let's place it over here. Yeah, it just doesn't look as vibrant as in the previous snapshot. It seems that the water source inside of these blocks don't have any current. So if I throw an item directly up against this, see if I can get it in there. There you see. It's not being forced out to the edges, where a normal water source, if you threw an item into it, it would take it along and move it. Now this can be really useful in some situations where you want to like align a mob and have them in water. Not sure what exactly, but you could see that you can line the mob really precisely between like a fence as well as like an iron bar. You can sit in here. Now something really strange I noticed about having iron bars on one side and a fence on the other side. If you press the forward key or the side keys, you'll get launched upwards like a ladder. So it's almost like you're climbing these. So I'll press side. Yeah, I'm pressing my side by moving, strafing to the left, and you can see I just climbed up this water. So yeah, definitely quite strange. It's only with the fences, because like here's a normal one and I press up against the sides, I don't swim upward. So yeah, I don't know what that's, not sure what's going on there, but it's pretty cool. It also works with like fences as well as cob walls on either side. And now I'm not swimming, so if I just press forward, you can see that I'm just using it like a ladder. There's also this weird rendering. You probably seen it there. If I go back in the water, yeah, you can see how some of the blocks or some of the chunks around me don't render right there. So if I press F3 and G, you can see there's definitely some kind of chunk rendering problem going on right there. Don't seem very useful. Like I can't see anything really like X-ray or anything like that, but it's definitely noticeable. It seems maybe the climbing mechanics inside of water is intended, because with ladders here, you can see that you can climb them up very quickly if there's water inside them. So that is a really nice feature. Now you still can't place lava on top of these blocks or in them. So if I right click, nothing will happen. And same goes if there's already water in it and you click on the block, you don't place the water above it. So they probably should implement some like shift clicking or something so that you can place water above it as well as inside of it. Some blocks still need tweaking, such as the cob wall, which when placed inside of water will destroy the water. They also reverted back the way that water sources are created. So just a couple snapshots ago, they had it so that if you had two water sources here, they would come and be able to create a water source here as long as there was a type of water below it. And now that is no longer the case. They will still create like water sources on the side if you would fill this in. But if there is a hole there, it will not create a water source. So I even show that with like a bucket. I try to click here. They fix a bug that flowing water downwards would create more sources. So if we remove the water, you can see that it removes all the sources. And if we remove the lava, it also removes all the sources. Now they fix a bug that sponges will remove the block as well as the water. Now they just remove the water. But they didn't fix the bug to do with a dispenser. So you can put like a bucket of water into a block. But once you try to retract it, it will also remove the iron bar itself. So you can kind of make a funny contraption, which is a trap chest, which we have full of some material. And then if we just put a water source here, and then we put an empty bucket in here, when you open up the trap chest, it will cause redstone to power this dispenser, which will remove the chest itself, as well as the water source, and just leave you with items. So I'll open this up, and yeah, see what happened? Just vanished. They also fixed a bug I showed in the last snapshot review, which where the water wasn't completely flowing down properly, and now you can see it looks more normal, making the oceans look more beautiful, as well as tons of new water mechanics which we can use in 1.13. So if you found this interesting, show me a like. If you'd like to see more snapshot reviews, subscribe, and don't forget, if you see anything in the snapshot that you want me to cover, tell me in the comments. Bye-bye!